If you are using Linux Mint 18 or any previous version of Linux Mint, now you are able to upgrade it to Linux Mint 19. In this video, you will see a step-by-step guide how to do that. Before you start upgrading to Linux Mint 19, I would like you to consider these important points. First, if you are using Linux Mint 17 or Linux Mint 18 and you are happy with your system, do not upgrade. These two systems will be supported until 2019 and 2021 respectively. So if it's unbroke, don't break it. But if you still want to upgrade, I recommend you to try Linux Mint 19 from live USB first. This way, you will be able to test how it performs on your system, and you will also see if you like the new Linux Mint. And the third point is to backup all your data. I have already published some videos on how to do backup. If you watched them before and you use those methods, you can use it to backup your data. Or you can install Timeshift, which was recently introduced as a backup tool for Linux Mint. Actually, this is what I am going to start this video with. In this tutorial, I will mostly use the terminal, because it is the most reliable way to do the upgrade. The first thing we need to do is to install Timeshift. Type sudo apt install Timeshift. Press enter. Here you need to enter your password blindly, so you see nothing when you type it. And press enter. The program Timeshift is being installed. Now you can go to the menu and open it. You need to enter your password. This wizard will help you to set up the backup process for your system. If you don't know what BatteryFS is, select rsync. Click next here. You need to wait for a while until the program will analyze the size of your system. Usually it automatically detects your hard drives and suggests you a place to do the backup. As you can see here, this is my system. And this is another hard drive which I used to create a backup. So here, at this step, you need to select a hard drive where to backup your system. I recommend you to use an external hard drive, for example a USB hard drive, which you can disconnect from your system for the upgrade process. So I select SDB1, this is my another hard drive which is connected to this system, while my system is installed on this hard drive. So I select it. If you are unsure about the hard drives and you don't understand their names here, you can also look at their size. So this will give you an idea where is your system and where is your hard drive for backup. For example, here as you can see, this hard drive has 21 gigs free, so it's completely empty. So I can backup everything here. I click next. Here, Timeshift suggests you to create a schedule for backup. In our case, it's not necessary because we're gonna do only one backup. So I don't select any schedule. Click next. And the setup is complete. Click finish. Now, this is a Timeshift interface. We have selected where to backup our system. We just need to make that backup. You need to click on this create button to create a system snapshot, so to backup everything from your system to an external hard drive. So it takes quite a while, so I will pause this video and will start again when the backup is complete. When the backup is complete, you will see this snapshot. You can use it to restore your system to the state before the upgrade. If the upgrade process fails completely and you cannot boot to your system anymore, you can also boot from a live USB, start the Timeshift program, navigate to your snapshot, and restore it. So now, when the data is backed up, we are safe to start the upgrade process. But before you do the upgrade, you need to completely update your system. So open the Update Manager and apply all the available updates. You can click Refresh first and install the updates. Next, you need to make sure that your Linux Mint version is 18.3. To check that, go to the menu and open the settings. In the settings, if you look for Info and open System Info, you will see the version of your Linux Mint. So if your Linux Mint version is 18.1 or 18.2, as in my case, you need to upgrade to the version 18.3. So let's do that. Open the Update Manager, and here in the Edit menu, you can see the option Update to Linux Mint 18.3. Click on it, and just follow this wizard. Click Next. Yes, if you want, you can read the release notes. I will click Next here. Again, new features. If you are curious, you can check these new features too. I will proceed. So here we are warned that after the upgrade we may experience some problems, but we have backed up our system, so if something goes wrong, we can always restore the previous state of the system. So it is fine. We agree we understand the risk and apply the upgrades. Enter the password. The upgrade process has started. You also need to wait quite a while until the system is upgraded. If you are curious, you can also click on these details and see more details about the upgrade process. I think it's more entertaining to see what's happening. And hopefully you will see the message that your operating system was successfully upgraded. But to complete this upgrade, it is good to reboot your system. Now let's check the version of our system again. Go to System Info, and as you can see, it is 18.3. So this is the version you need to upgrade to Linux Mint 19. Also, Linux Mint 19 as well as Linux Mint 18.3 change the display manager. So we need to check what display manager currently is installed on your system, and if it's not YDM, you need to change it to YDM. To check your current display manager, type cat etc x11 default display manager and press enter. As you can see here, on my system it is MDM display manager, and this is not what you need to make the upgrade. So let's replace this MDM display manager with YDM display manager. You type sudo apt install YDM YDM settings and slick greeter. Enter your password and agree to install these packages. Okay, here this is very important step. You need to select YDM here, because this is a new display manager, the one we need to make the upgrade successful. Select YDM and press enter. Now you can remove MDM display manager. Type sudo apt remove with option purge MDM mint MDM themes. Yes, remove it. Now you need to reconfigure YDM. To do that, type sudo dpkg reconfigure YDM and press enter. After these steps, reboot your system. Here's our new YDM display manager. This is how it was before, and this is how it is now. Enter your password and log in into the system. Before we start the actual upgrade process, there is one more preparation step. If you configured Update Manager to use local mirror, you need to switch back to the standard mirror. To do that, go to Edit, Software Sources, enter your password, and here in the mirrors, you need to select the standard Linux Mint mirrors. To do that, simply click here, restore to the default settings. Now we have the standard mirrors. Update the cache, open the terminal, and let's start the upgrade process. First, you need to install Mint upgrade. To do that, type sudo apt install mint upgrade. Again, enter your password blindly and press enter. Next, you need to run kind of a dry upgrade process. So this way you will be able to check how the upgrade process will happen on your system, but nothing will be actually changed on your system. You type mint upgrade with the command check and press enter. Now you simply need to follow the instructions on the screen. Yes, we want to continue. Basically, this dry run will help us to understand if the upgrade process is possible. During the upgrade process, it is possible that the upgrade program will remove some packages. You will need to install them back. It will happen during this step. So we agree here, yes. And we will need to take notes of those programs which have been removed during the upgrade process. So now if you scroll up, you can see what packages will be removed. As you can see here, the following packages will be removed. So check all these packages. Some of them should be removed because they are from older version of Linux Mint. But if there are some packages which you installed deliberately and they are removed by this upgrade tool, you will need to reinstall them back. So simply take notes of those packages. In my case, I use mostly the default programs, so nothing important will be removed. I can proceed with the upgrade. You can also see here that there was no error and no problems, so it means we are safe to start the actual upgrade process. Let's clean this screen. And the first step will be to download the packages we need for the upgrade. Again, we type mint upgrade with the option download. So this step doesn't do the upgrade, it simply downloads all the packages which are required for the upgrade. So this step changes the repositories of your system. If for some reason you don't want to upgrade and you want to restore the repositories from your previous version of Linux Mint, you can run the command mint upgrade restore sources. Yes, here. So the download process takes quite a while because we're downloading the completely new version of the distribution. Now when all the packages are downloaded, we can run the upgrade program. So keep in mind, after this step, everything will be irreversible. So if you need to do any changes or you forgot something, go back and do the changes. So for example, if you have not backed up your system, go back and do the backup. So again, you need to run the command mint upgrade with the option upgrade. Yes. So here is additional warning that it is not reversible. We understand that and we say yes here again. The upgrade process to Linux Mint 19 Tara has started. If you see something like this, you simply need to accept this license. You can scroll it with your arrow keys on the keyboard, and to accept it, you need to press the tab key and enter. Again, you select yes with your arrow keys on the keyboard and press enter. You may also be asked to enter your password, so do that. So as you can see, there is a warning here. So during the upgrade process, the program tried to create this file fstab.upgraded, but it failed to do so. So there was some error in the script. But this is okay because I know that my fstab file is fine. If you are unsure about your files, you can always check their content. For example, we can type cat atc fstab. So this is the original file which will be used during the boot of our system. If you type here backup, this is the backed up version. This is the version I saved before, so it was created by me because I remember I created it. And if you check these two files, you will see that this number and these numbers are different. But it is okay because I changed it, I know that this number is the correct one. And there was a third package, which was the pkg save, you can check it too. So again, you can see these are the two drives which will be mounted on my system. It ends with C4. This one ends with 33 and this one ends with C4. But I know that C4 was correct. So everything is fine, I know that these files are correct. I will try to reboot now and hopefully I will be booted into my new Linux Mint 19. The first good sign, we already see the loading of Linux Mint 19. So the system has booted successfully. Let's log in. Here it is, Linux Mint 19. Let's go to the system info and check it. Yes, as you can see, it is Linux Mint 19 with the kernel 4.15. Let's check if everything has been upgraded. To do that, you can simply run sudo apt update. Basically, we're just going to check for updates and try to install if there are any updates available which were not installed during the upgrade process. First, we will update the cache with the command update, and now we can modify this command to the upgrade. Now, nothing is fine, everything has been upgraded successfully, and some packages were not removed. As you can see here, it suggests us to run this command to remove these packages. Let's do it. Yes, we want to remove these obsolete packages. Basically, if you check these packages, you will see why it suggests us to remove it. Because it is Linux kernel 4.10, which is the obsolete version, it was installed with the previous Linux Mint. Now we have a new kernel, and some other packages are also just obsolete. So let's remove them. So the system has been cleaned, and this means we have successfully upgraded to Linux Mint 19. I also would like to mention that the official upgrade page from Linux Mint says that your system may get stuck after the upgrade process, so it gets stuck at dev mapper crypt swap 1. If it happens, just follow these instructions to fix it. As you have seen, it didn't happen for me, luckily. Also keep in mind, if you have no success upgrading to Linux Mint 19, you can also consider an option to make a fresh install. But with that option, you will also need to install all non-default programs yourself. Linux Mint is the most polished distribution out there, so usually the upgrade process goes smoothly. But I still recommend you to wait a few months until everything is checked and all the possible bugs are fixed, so this way you will be safe. You're of course welcome to upgrade right now, but to be sure that you will have as little problem as possible, I recommend you to upgrade like in 2 months. So if this video helped you to upgrade, please give it a like. If you have experienced any problem, you're welcome to post it down in the comments. I or my other viewers will do their best to help you. Thank you for watching.